Hey, Tom Lounge is here, and it is time for the Spotlight Album of the Week. Yes, indeed it is. I know Jerry's out there listening with bated breath, waiting to find out what it is. Well, I'll tell you, Jerry and everybody else listening out there, we're going to go back to 1978. This album came out September 1st of 1978. It's the self-titled debut album from a band out of Jacksonville, Florida, by the name of Molly Hatchet. That's right. We're going to go back to that first album that introduced us to the band and gave us songs like Gator Country, Cheatin' Woman, The Creeper, Bounty Hunter, and of course their treatment of Dreams I'll Never See, an old Allman's Brothers song. You know, in the mid-60s, most of the world was embracing the Beatles and the Stones and all the British invasion hoopla that was going on, and the rest of them were embracing the soul explosion that was happening. Well, these lads out of Jacksonville, Florida, were getting into Macon, Georgia, Muscle Shoals, things like that. It wasn't that big of a sound yet. Of course, we'd come to realize later the importance of Macon and Muscle Shoals Studios and the Miami Empires they had. But the Molly Hatchet guys, well, they got into it very early on. And you can hear it on this debut album. Now, before I play the album, I'm going to tell you a little personal story. There is a connection to the region here with Molly Hatchet. I'll share that in just a bit with a local band out of the Lake Station area, in fact. But before this album came out, Epic Records, their label, threw a party at Park West in Chicago. And I was one of the first journalists to ever interview Molly Hatchet. And it ran in Night Rock News, which was owned by Hegwisch Records at the time. I was the editor of it. Hegwisch was the publisher. And I did an interview with the Hatchet Boys. Now, I was a relatively young reporter. They were a relatively young band. They had just been signed, had never really done interviews. I'd never really done a lot of interviews. So we had some great conversations. Well, neither of us thought to see if anything was off the record. Well, there was a few things that made it into the interview that should have probably not. And it set the bar for me learning when to go with a gut feeling and say, that's really good stuff, but I don't know if that's really something I should say. Well, anyway, long story short, some stuff got printed in that first article that caused a little bit of a ripple. But Hatchet and I stayed friends over the years. They played later at Club Dimension in Highland when I was working there. And a group that I was working with out of Lake Station called Deep River Band, later be known as Shut Up and Drive. Well, we set them on tour with Hatchet, and everything was going well. Dave Hublick founded the band in 1971. Sadly, we just lost Dave not too long ago. So we're going to dedicate tonight's debut album to his memory. He was the last to shuffle off this mortal coil. We've lost Steve Holland, we lost Banner Thomas, we lost Dwayne Rowland, and Danny Joe Brown all have shuffled off. Dave, I believe, is the last was the last one standing, and now he's gone as well. So to my best experience, I think all of the original members are now gone, but Molly Hatchet is continuing. The legacy continues with some Southern Fried boogie-woogie rock and roll, and it is a different incarnation, but the music is still pretty darn good. But I don't think they ever got better than the first two albums. The second one, of course, Flirtin' with Disaster, came out in 1979. The debut, self-titled, in 1978, and that is tonight's album. This one featured on the cover a painting by Frank Frazetta called Death Dealer. And I remember that cover from an old Creepy magazine. Remember Creepy and Eerie magazines and Vampirella? Well, they used a lot of Frank Frazetta stuff, very gothic stuff. And back then, nobody was using stuff that was that dark and gothic, except, of course, the Hatchet Boys. Because, after all, they were named after a fictitious serial killer named Hatchet Molly. Now, I never did find out if Hatchet Molly was really a killer or merely just urban legend, but it doesn't really matter because it's a cool name. So they took Hatchet Molly's name, transposed it to Molly Hatchet, and a legend was born, with Frank Frazetta covers then adorning all of the Molly Hatchet albums to come. And in later days, they got some guy to do a knockoff of a Frazetta style. But hey, it's cool. So are you ready? I know I am. I'm going to go back to 1978 with that debut album right now. This is Molly Hatchet and Bounty Hunter.
Yeah.
Molly Hatchet, self-titled 1978, is our feature album, Heading Down to Gator Country. Dave Hublick, Steve Holland, Banner Thomas wrote this one, clocking in at 6:17.
He's calling.
Does it get any better than that? Triple Guitar Army. That is the trademark of Southern Rock from Jacksonville. It was the trademark with the Outlaws out of Tampa Town, also Lynyrd Skynyrd, and of course the Hatchet Boys and the Almonds. So good stuff there, Guitar-Driven Army. That was Gator Country. We've got Big Apple coming up now, followed by The Creeper and The Price You Pay. Side one, Molly Hatchet self-titled, playing for you now on RegionRadio.live. Molly Hatchet, blowing the dust off their debut album, 1978. This came out on Epic Records, produced by Mr. Ted Templeman. You remember, I'm sorry, not Ted Templeman, Tom Werman. More on him later. The Creeper.
Watch out for Steve Blake, baby, home.
Creepers coming. So's the last song of side one, The Price You Pay. Molly Hatchet, 78, debut music. Spotlight album tonight on the Vintage Lounge. And that wraps up side one of Molly Hatchet's debut album from 1978, the self-titled Molly Hatchet album. Again, that's the one that had Death Dealer on the front cover. That was a Frank Frazetta classic illustration. And that is the album that gave us the songs we just heard. The Price You Pay, The Creeper, Big Apple, Gator Country, and Bounty Hunter. Again, this album released September 1st, 1978 on Epic Records. Tom Werman is the guy that produced the album. And Tom Werman is a very interesting character. Not only did he produce Molly Hatchet, but he also went on to produce acts like Blue Oyster Cult. Motley Crue was probably one of his greatest accomplishments and put him on the map. Kix, LA Guns, and Poison. He was the man behind all the lever moves on those groups. And he later went on to work with, believe it or not, the Backstreet Boys. That's right. He had his hands in a little bit of everything over the years. He was an A&R guy and a record producer from 1970 to 1982 was his probably peak year with Epic. And Tom Werman, good guy there. Molly Hatchet is our spotlight album. And it's interesting because I told you how I interviewed them before this album even came out. And one of the things that we did talk about was their admiration for the Allman Brothers, as well as Lynyrd Skynyrd. And those guys grew up in the same hometown as Skynyrd, kind of like a local version here. We had Styx, and we had M&R Rush and some other groups that came up under Styx that had very much respect for them and kind of emulated their sound a bit. Well, Molly Hatchet took the three-guitar assault and basically tried to fill the void that happened with Skynyrd after the plane crash, and they did a good job. They're probably one of the more better-known Southern rock bands of all time behind Skynyrd. In fact, 38 Special, which featured Donnie Van Zant, lead singer of 38 Special, Donnie Van Zant, also the sibling of Ronnie Van Zant of Skynyrd, who perished in a plane crash. Donnie took Molly Hatchet and introduced him to Epic Records and to Tom Werman and to their manager, Pat Armstrong, who also handled an awful lot of great Southern rock talent. So they kind of had a really strong connection there with the Skynyrd clan because of being from the hometown of Jacksonville. And as I mentioned, there is a connection to Molly Hatchet here in Northwest Indiana that goes beyond me being one of the first journalists to interview them. Deep River Band out of Lake Station, later become Shut Up and Drive, who were still out there doing their thing. They went out, and Dave Hublick used to jump up and jam with them when they were touring down south in Florida. Dave would follow the band around, and he would pop up, and he would join them on stage. So that was kind of an interesting thing, and they became very good friends. He was a big supporter of Deep River, Shut Up and Drive, and sadly, we lost Dave Hublick just about a year or so ago. He passed away. The last man standing from the original lineup. The album we're featuring has Bruce Crump on drums, Banner Thomas on bass, of course, the triple guitar army of Dave Hublick, Dwayne Rowland, and Steve Holland, and the lead singer there, Danny Joe Brown, one of the nicest guys you'd ever want to meet. Danny sadly passed away from complications of diabetes, but I got a chance to work pretty closely with Danny when he was doing shows in Highland, Indiana, my hometown, at Club Dimension. They played there a couple of times, and we also welcomed them during the Night Rock era to Hammond Civic Center. So I got a chance to work with the guys there too once Flirtin' with Disaster came out, and after that they also had a couple of different group changes, I guess you'd say. They had Jimmy Farah join them after the first couple of albums. He joined them for their third album, which was Beatin' the Odds, which actually did pretty good for him. But Danny Joe came back, and the original lineup was back together. But that's a story for another day. Let's get back into our debut album from Molly Hatchet. This is one of the greatest albums ever of Southern rock, arguably, of course. And they pay tribute to one of their early idols, as I mentioned, not only Skynyrd, but the Allman Brothers. I told you in the beginning, they were very into the making sound. So this is their treatment of Dreams I'll Never See, a tune written by Greg Allman and recorded here a little bit differently than the Allman Brothers by Molly Hatchet. Dreams I'll Never See, kicking off side two from 1978. Enjoy, and feel free to turn it up. Clocking in at 7:06, their treatment of the Allman Brothers' Dreams I'll Never See. Molly Hatchet, 1978, this album came out. That was track one of side two. This is I'll Be Running.
Oh,
All right, that wraps up Molly Hatchet, side two, of the self-titled Molly Hatchet album, 1978, that came out. Again, good stuff. It introduced the country and the world to Molly Hatchet. Tom Werman produced it at the Record Plant in Los Angeles. It featured the original lineup, founded in 1971 by Dave Hublick, the guitar player, the last man standing of the group who just passed away. Prior to his passing, we also lost all the other original members. Steve Holland, another guitar player, Dwayne Rowland on guitar, Banner Thomas on bass, Bruce Crump on drums, and the late great singer Danny Joe Brown. Gotta love any album that starts off with, hell yeah! All right, good stuff. Death Dealer on the cover, great music inside. You heard all nine tracks. And that wraps up tonight's Spotlight album, Molly Hatchet. Remember, this is Vintage Lounge, broadcasting live from 218 Main Street in downtown Hobart. This is The Record Bin, Tom Lounge's Record Bin, and I am Tom Lounge's, your host. So if you want to hear certain albums, by all means, tell us what you want by going to Facebook and Friends of Vintage Lounge. Friends of Vintage Lounge. That's all you got to do. Or go to the Region Radio page, regionradio.live, and let the good doctor there know what you want to hear on this station, and he'll pass the word along to me. We'll be playing more albums as we get into the winter months, and I'm getting stir-crazy and cabin fever. It won't be just weekly. I may be doing two or three on a Thursday. I may also be doing one every day. You never know. Because that's the wonder of internet radio. We don't have to play by the rules. Because we know you don't like to. And we don't either. So if you want to hear some great albums, or maybe just album sides. Maybe we'll do a side of an album. And then the side of another album. Side one of this album, side two of another album. We can do all sorts of fun stuff. Because we have thrown the rule book out the window. Well, for now, I'm going to leave you in memory of the Molly Hatchet guys. Because they are from Florida. And they're kicking it up. Green grass and high tides. This is the Outlaws. Stay with me.